Hello and welcome to the International Daily Roundup by People's Dispatch, where we bring you major news developments from around the world. Our headlines: at least 3 people killed after Afghan flag raised during protest in Jalalabad. New report documents human rights violations during 2019 Bolivian coup. Climate change and lack of safety place outdoor workers in the US at growing risk. Protesters topple statue of Canada's first PM for atrocities against First Nations. In our first story, at least 3 people were reportedly killed in the Afghan city of Jalalabad on August 18th. Witnesses told Reuters that the violence took place during a protest against the Taliban. Local residents had tried to hoist Afghanistan's national flag at a square in the city. It was then that the Taliban fighters opened fire, leaving more than a dozen people injured. Al Jazeera reported that hundreds of protesters had also gathered in the Khost province. The killings on Wednesday took place just as Taliban leaders are meeting with Afghan politicians. The group has stated that it wants to form an inclusive government. Taliban deputy leader Mullah Abdul Ghani Baradar has also arrived in Kandahar. Meanwhile, the UAE has announced that it is hosting ousted President Ashraf Ghani. The US has also frozen the Afghan central bank's assets worth nearly $9.5 billion. Around 5,000 diplomats and civilians have been evacuated from the country so far. However, the ANP news agency reported that US forces did not allow any Afghans to enter the Kabul airport on Tuesday night. 17 people were also reportedly wounded during a stampede at a gate on Wednesday. This was just 2 days after at least 7 people were killed as thousands of Afghans fled to the airport. In our next story, the Interdisciplinary Group of Independent Experts has released its report on the 2019 Bolivian coup. The report states that the Jeanine Anez regime was responsible for massacres and summary executions. These include the violence at Sencata, Sacaba, Pedregal and La Paz. At least 38 people were killed and hundreds of others were left seriously injured. The report examined the period between September 1st and December 31st, 2019. The GIEI interviewed over 400 people and examined over 120,000 documents. The report points to discrimination against the indigenous, rural and poor people. Far-right groups also use religion, including the Bible, to justify the actions against Evo Morales. 28 cases of racism have been identified by the GIEI between October and November 2019. The group has also documented the systematic use of torture and sexual abuse against young indigenous detainees. Military forces were protected from any criminal responsibility under Decree 4078. The landmark report was presented to Bolivian President Luis Arce on August 17th. He announced that a census of the victims will be conducted and reparations will be given. The immunity granted to the coup regime security forces will also be revoked. Meanwhile, all paramilitary and illegal armed groups formed during the coup will be disbanded. President Arce has also asked the prosecutor's office to implement the recommendations made in the report. We now go to the US, where at least 384 workers have died from environmental heat exposure in the last decade. They include people working on essential jobs such as farm labor, garbage collection and construction. At least 12 companies have had more than one worker die from heat. These findings are part of a new report by NPR and Columbia Journalism Investigations. In some cases, the workers died after not having enough water and scheduled breaks in the shade. People of color have been disproportionately impacted. The report found that Hispanic workers accounted for 1/3 of all heat fatalities. Moreover, the Occupation Safety and Health Administration, that is the OSHA, often did not penalize companies for worker deaths. If it did, it reduced violations and fines after negotiations. The official death tally has also been vastly undercounted. OSHA has not adopted a national heat standard to protect workers. Under current rules, companies are only required to provide water and no other safety measures. These findings were published alongside another report by the Union of Concerned Scientists. Rising temperatures due to greenhouse gas emissions will make outdoor working conditions more unsafe. Workers in the US could face up to 4 times as many days with hazardous heat by 2065. Without proper measures in place, workers will face reduced working hours and income losses. Between 4.1 to 7.1 million workers could see their earnings cut by 10% per year. Once again, Black and Latinx people, who comprise 40% of all outdoor workers, will be especially hit. UCS argues that these income losses will worsen inequities in health outcomes and poverty rates. And finally, 6 more First Nation communities have launched inquiries into residential school sites in Canada. This follows the discoveries of over 1,300 unmarked graves at these sites since May. During a protest on August 14, people tore down the statue of former Prime Minister John Macdonald. This was after the Hamilton City Council decided not to remove the statue. Macdonald was responsible for some of the worst atrocities against Indigenous people. It was during his time that Canada adopted the residential industrial school system. Here is a video feature on Saturday's protest. Thank you. That's all we have time for today. We'll be back tomorrow with more news from around the world. Until then, keep watching People's Dispatch.